He stole into this abandoned Belgian mansion. What he discovered next was seriously creepy. As author Ransom Riggs slowly made his way through an old, abandoned mansion, he caught a glimpse of something at the end of a corridor that must have sent shivers down his spine. This was surely much more than he'd bargained for when he went urban exploring in Belgium. "I just flew back from the strangest trip of my life," Riggs later explained at the beginning of a short film documenting his bizarre journey visiting some of Northern Europe's abandoned castles and mansions. The reason for the trip, though, was innocent enough. You see, Riggs had traveled from Los Angeles to Amsterdam, in the Netherlands, to film a trailer for the release of his first novel, Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. But Riggs couldn't do it all on his own, so he got in touch with someone who knew their way around spooky sites. In fact, he enlisted the aid of Martino Ziguard, one of his favorite urban explorers, to help him track down and enter into grand, abandoned buildings around Belgium and Luxembourg. The plan was to find a place that looked like the gnarly old building Riggs describes in his novel. Indeed, they were searching for a real-life home for peculiar children, and it is safe to say that they found it. In fact, after Riggs arrived in the Belgian countryside to explore his first home with Ziguard, things were already weird. The building, after all, seemed to mirror exactly the house that he had envisioned when writing his debut novel. Riggs even says as much in the video, confessing that it was so close to what I imagined. He goes to say, "Confronted by it now, I feel an uncomfortable sense of déjà vu. But inside was a very different story. In fact, the interior of the house was a wreck, roots hung from the ceilings, and the floor was rotting away. It was eerie, but Riggs and Ziguard were only just getting started." Riggs and Ziguard found another dilapidated home in the center of a Belgian village and walked in. The explorers made their way down a corridor, and in the distance they could see something sinister hanging in a closet. It was a single suit, dangling alone. As they headed downstairs, they discovered an actual cave, complete with a bar and mirrored ceiling. But it was in an old outhouse where things started to get really creepy. Riggs found a workshop through a tangled mass of greenery. It seemed to have belonged to a man who had made garden statues. Heads and limbs of never finished pieces lay strewn across the floor. It was as if the old man had died before he could finish his last project, suggests Riggs in his film. Old newspapers from the 1950s lay alongside paint pots and brushes, too, and they were still vivid all these years later. Next, the men left this place, and Belgium, behind and continued their intriguing journey into Luxembourg. They eventually came to a house that was as much like stepping into a time capsule as any I've been in, according to Riggs. A door that looked as though it had been sealed in with cobwebs led to a room that time forgot. Everything arranged as if the owner had just stepped out for a quart of milk 50 years ago, Riggs commented. And there could not have been a better description for the place. It was a house full of ghosts from the past. But the explorers were still in for the biggest shock of the trip. This was to come in the final house, and it was one that looked as though it belonged to someone very wealthy. The guys found a stack of beds in the attic, for instance, and an antique-looking mirror. As they made their way through the house, they came across another object, surely the creepiest thing they had found by far. It was a grave marker, and it was just sitting on top of a pile of rubble inside the house. Riggs' hunt to create the perfect trailer for his book may have taken a few surprising turns, but it was probably this that caused the video of his adventure to go viral. Indeed, at the time of writing, the short documentary had garnered more than 4 million YouTube views. And the book didn't do too badly, either. As well as becoming a New York Times bestseller in April 2012, Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children reached number 1 on the children's chapter books list. And, as well as leading to 2 sequels, the success of Riggs' debut novel caught the attention of Hollywood. A Tim Burton-directed film adaptation of the book is due to be released by 20th Century Fox in the fall of 2016. The question is, will it be as gripping as Rigg's explorations?